Well, we're going into a second lockdown to slow the spread of the coronavirus. I feel like I'm stuck watching a sequel of a movie that nobody really liked in the first place. And so far, the sequel is even worse than the original. But we all have to sit through it anyway. And sit through it we must. Whatever your opinion is about lockdowns, pandemics, masks, and so on, we all need to be kind, loving, law-abiding people who protect the vulnerable. So, hunker down, everybody. We are officially doing this. But we need to do it better. I don't know about you, but I did not do well in the first lockdown. I lost a lot of things that were really important to me, and the only thing I gained was a few pounds around my midsection. My mental and physical health took a beating. And according to the statistics, I'm not the only one. Turns out that a lot of us ate more, smoked more, drank more, and exercised and socialized a whole lot less. But now is not the time to despair. By now, I think we've all noticed that there's good hope for vaccines in the coming months. There are finally indicators that this nightmare will eventually end. But more importantly, now is the time when we remember that all nightmares eventually end. Do you ever think about where Christmas falls in our calendar? It's right at the winter solstice, the shortest day and the longest night of the year. For centuries, people have celebrated that night, not because they prefer dark to light, but because that is the point in time when the light rallies and the darkness is in retreat. And at that point in the physical world, that's when we remember that the light of Christ drives back all darkness. So, I'm telling a different story with my life this lockdown. Yes, this is going to be a cold, dark, and lonely time, but only for a season. The light is coming, and I am focused on that. I will not live in fear. I will find peace and joy in Jesus. I will find my true hope and community in Him. I will not hear the lies of the enemy. I will believe that I am a child of God and that He looks after every one of my needs. And I will know that no virus, no lockdown, no pandemic, no power on earth can separate me from love and fellowship with my God. Are those messages that you could use in your life too? If so, you're in luck. Those are the central themes of a few Christmas productions that we're going to be bringing you in December. We're going to be showing them on Foothills TV on Fridays at 7 o'clock. And on the second Friday, we're going to be bringing you a brand new production called Four Shepherds. We couldn't shoot that one in front of a live studio audience, had to shoot it like a regular movie. Look, I understand that meeting online is not the same. Okay, I get it. I love this building too. And one of the great joys of my life and the calling on my life is to tell the gospel story on that stage in there. And I can't do that anymore. But that is not the church. We are the church. And thanks be to God that we can use technology to still meet as the church. Friends, this is the time to lean in. This is the time to attend church online, gather in life groups online, and join us on Fridays to remember Jesus Christ, the light of the world. This season, we invite you to rebuke despair and depression and embrace joy and celebration. Let's walk into this second lockdown like we carry the hope and the healing of this world with us everywhere we go. Because we do. See you in the chat room.